This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. A propeller is a type of fan that transmits power by converting rotational motion into thrust. A pressure difference is produced between the forward and rear surfaces of the airfoil-shaped blade, and a fluid such as air or water is accelerated behind the blade. Propeller dynamics, like those of aircraft wings, can be modeled by either or both Bernoulli's principle and Newton's third law. A marine propeller of this type is sometimes colloquially known as a screw propeller or screw. However, there is a different class of propellers known as cycloidal propellers. They are characterized by the higher propulsive efficiency, averaging 0.72 compared to the screw propeller's average of 0.6, and the ability to throw thrust in any direction at any time. Their disadvantages are higher mechanical complexity and higher cost contents. 1. History. 11. Early developments. 12. Screw propellers. 13. Aircraft propellers. 2. Propeller theory. 21. History. 22. Theory of operation. 23. Marine propeller cavitation. 24. Forces acting on a foil. 25. Propeller thrust. 251. Single blade. 252. Thrust and torque. 26. Actual performance. 3 types of marine propellers. 31. Controllable pitch propeller. 32. Skewback propeller. 33. Modular propeller. 4. Protection of small engines. 5. See also. 51. Propeller characteristics. 52. Propeller phenomena. 53. Propeller variations. 531. Cleaver. 532. Other. 54. Materials and manufacture. 6. Notes. 7. External links. History. Early developments. The principle employed in using a screw propeller is used in sculling. It is part of the skill of propelling a Venetian gondola, but was used in a less refined way in other parts of Europe and probably elsewhere. For example, propelling a canoe with a single paddle using a pitch stroke or side slipping a canoe with a scull involves a similar technique in China. Sculling, called lu, was also used by the 3rd century AD in sculling. A single blade is moved through an arc from side to side, taking care to keep presenting the blade to the water at the effective angle. The innovation introduced with the screw propeller was the extension of that arc through more than 360 degrees by attaching the blade to a rotating shaft. Propellers can have a single blade, but in practice there are nearly always more than one so as to balance the forces involved. Archimedes screw. The origin of the screw propeller starts with Archimedes, who used a screw to lift water for irrigation and bailing boats, so famously that it became known as Archimedes screw. It was probably an application of spiral movement in space. Spirals were a special study of Archimedes. To a hollow segmented water wheel used for irrigation by Egyptians for centuries. Leonardo da Vinci adopted the principle to drive his theoretical helicopter, sketches of which involved a large canvas screw overhead in 1784. J.P. Pockshin proposed a gyrocopter-like aircraft using similar screws for both lift and propulsion at about the same time. James Watt proposed using screws to propel boats, although he did not use them for his steam engines. This was not his own invention, though Toogood and Hayes had patented it a century earlier, and it had become a common use as a means of propelling boats since that time. By 1827, Czech-Austrian inventor Joseph Ressel had invented a screw propeller which had multiple blades fastened around a conical base. He had tested his propeller in February 1826 on a small ship that was manually driven. He was successful in using his bronze screw propeller on an adapted steamboat. 1829, his ship Civetta, with 48 gross register tons, reached a speed of about 6 knots 11. The vessel burned coal. John Patch, a mariner in Yarmouth, Nova Scotia, developed a two-bladed, fan-shaped propeller in 1832 and publicly demonstrated it in 1833, propelling a rowboat across Yarmouth Harbour and a small coastal schooner at St. John, New Brunswick, but his patent application in the United States was rejected until 1849 because he was not an American citizen. His efficient design drew praise in American scientific circles, but by this time there were multiple competing versions of the marine propeller screw propellers. Although there was much experimentation with screw propulsion until the 1830s, few of these inventions were pursued to the testing stage, and those that were, proved unsatisfactory for one reason or another. Propellers of the RMS. First on a pond at his Hendon farm, and later at the Royal Adelaide Gallery of Practical Science in London, where it was seen by the Secretary of the Navy, Sir William Barrow. Having secured the patronage of a London banker named Wright, Smith then built a 30-foot, 6-horsepower canal boat of 6 tons burthen called the Francis Smith, which was fitted with a wooden propeller of his own design and demonstrated on the Paddington Canal from November 1836 to September 1837. By a fortuitous accident, the wooden propeller of 2 turns was damaged damaged during a voyage in February 1837, and to Smith's surprise the broken propeller, which now consisted of only a single turn, doubled the boat's previous speed, from about 4 miles an hour to 8. Smith would subsequently file a revised patent in keeping with this accidental discovery. In the meantime, Ericsson built a 45-foot screw-propelled steamboat, Francis B. Ogden, in 1837, and demonstrated his boat on the River Thames to senior members of the British Admiralty, including Surveyor of the Navy Sir William Simmons. In spite of the boat achieving a speed of 10 miles an hour, comparable with that of existing paddle steamers, Simmons and his entourage were unimpressed. The Admiralty maintained the view that screw propulsion would be ineffective in ocean-going service, while Simmons himself believed that screw-propelled ships could not be steered efficiently. Following this rejection, Ericsson built a second, larger screw-propelled boat, the Robert F. Stockton, and had her sailed in 1839 to the United States, where he was soon to gain fame as the designer of the U.S. Navy's first screw-propelled warship, USS Propulsion by the Royal Navy. In addition to her influence on commercial vessels' trials with Smith's SS Archimedes led to the famous tug-of-war competition in 1845 between the screw-driven HMS Rattler and the paddle steamer HMS Electo, the former pulling the latter backward at 25 knots 46. Requirements to handle more power in smaller diameter have made the problem more complex. Alberto Santos Dumont, another early pioneer, applied the knowledge he gained from experiences with airships to make a propeller with a steel shaft and aluminium blades for his 14-bis biplane. Some of his designs used a bent aluminium sheet for blades, thus creating an airfoil shape. They were heavily undercambered, and this plus the absence of lengthwise twist made them less efficient than the Wright propellers. Even so, this was perhaps the first use of aluminium in the construction of an airscrew propeller. Theory history. In the second half of the 19th century, several theories were developed: the momentum theory or disk actuator theory, a theory describing a mathematical model of an ideal propeller, was developed by W. J. M. Rankine 1865, Alfred George Greenhill 1888, and Ree Froude 1889. The propeller is modeled as an infinitely thin disk, inducing a constant velocity along the axis of rotation. This disk creates a flow around the propeller under certain mathematical premises of the fluid. There can be extracted a mathematical connection between power, radius of the propeller, torque, and induced velocity. Friction is not included. The blade element theory. BET is a mathematical process originally designed by William Froude 1878, David W. Taylor 1893, and Stefan Juitsky to determine the behavior of propellers. It involves breaking an airfoil down into several small parts, then determining the forces on them. These forces are then converted into accelerations, which can be integrated into velocities and positions. Theory of operation. Marine propeller nomenclature. 1. Trailing edge. 2. Face. 3. Fillet area. 4. Hub or boss. 5. Hub or boss cap. 6. Leading edge. 7. Back. 8. Propeller shaft. 9. Stern tube bearing. 10. Stern tube. A propeller is the most common propulsor on ships, imparting momentum to a fluid which causes a force to act on the ship. The ideal efficiency of any size propeller free tip is that of an actuator disc in an ideal fluid. An actual marine propeller is made up of sections of helicoidal surfaces which act together, screwing through the water. Hence the common reference to marine propellers as screws. 3, 4, or 5 blades are most common in marine propellers, although designs which are intended to operate at reduced noise will have more blades. The blades are attached to a boss hub, which should be as small as the needs of strength allow. With fixed pitch propellers, the blades and boss are usually a single casting. An alternative design is the controllable pitch propeller, CPP or CRP for controllable reversible pitch, where the blades are rotated normally to the drive shaft by additional machinery, usually hydraulics, at the hub and control linkages running down the shaft. This allows the drive machinery to operate at a constant speed while the propeller loading is changed to match operating conditions. It also eliminates the need for a reversing gear and allows for more rapid change to thrust, as the revolutions are constant. This type of propeller is most common on ships such as tugs, where there can be enormous differences in propeller loading when towing compared to running free, a change which could cause conventional propellers to lock up as insufficient torque is generated. The downsides of a CPP, CRP include the large hub which decreases the torque required to cause cavitation, the mechanical complexity which limits transmission power, and the extra blade shaping requirements forced upon the propeller designer. For smaller motors, there are self-pitching propellers. The blades freely move through an entire circle on an axis at right angles to the shaft. This allows hydrodynamic and centrifugal forces to set the angle the blades reach and so the pitch of the propeller. A propeller that turns clockwise to produce forward thrust, when viewed from aft, is called right-handed. One that turns anti-clockwise is said to be left-handed. Larger vessels often have twin screws to reduce heeling torque. Counter-rotating propellers, the starboard screw is usually right-handed and the port left-handed. This is called outward turning. The opposite case is called inward turning. Another possibility is contra-rotating propellers, where two propellers rotate in opposing directions on a single shaft, or on separate shafts on nearly the same axis. Contra-rotating propellers offer increased efficiency by capturing the energy lost in the tangential velocities imparted to the fluid by the forward propeller, known as propeller swirl. The flow field behind the aft propeller of a contra-rotating set has very little swirl, and this reduction in energy loss is seen as an increased efficiency of the aft propeller. An azimuthing propeller is a propeller that turns around the vertical axis. The individual airfoil-shaped blades turn as the propeller moves so that they are always generating lift in the vessel's direction of movement. This type of propeller can reverse or change its direction of thrust very quickly. Fixed-wing aircraft are also subject to the P-factor effect, in which a rotating propeller will yaw an aircraft slightly to one side because the relative wind it produces is asymmetrical. It is particularly noticeable when climbing, but is usually simple to compensate for with the aircraft's rudder. A more serious situation can exist if a multi-engine aircraft loses power to one of its engines, in particular the one which is positioned on the side that enhances the P-factor. This power plant is called the critical engine, and its loss will require more control compensation by the pilot. Marine propeller cavitation. Cavitating propeller in water tunnel experiment. Cavitation damage evident on the propeller of a personal watercraft. Cavitation is the formation of vapor bubbles in water near a moving propeller blade in regions of low pressure due to Bernoulli's principle. It can occur if an attempt is made to transmit too much power through the screw, or if the propeller is operating at a very high speed. Cavitation can waste power, create vibration and wear, and cause damage to the propeller. It can occur in many ways on a propeller. The two most common types of propeller cavitation are suction side surface cavitation and tip vortex cavitation. Suction side surface cavitation forms when the propeller is operating at high rotational speeds or under heavy load. High blade lift coefficient. The pressure on the upstream surface of the blade, the suction side, can drop below the vapor pressure of the water, resulting in the formation of a vapor pocket. Under such conditions, the change in pressure between the downstream surface of the blade, the pressure side, and the suction side is limited, and eventually reduced as the extent of cavitation is increased. When most of the blade surface is covered by cavitation, the pressure difference between the pressure side and suction side of the blade drops considerably, as does the thrust produced by the propeller. This condition is called thrust breakdown. Operating the propeller under these conditions wastes energy, generates considerable noise, and as the vapor bubbles collapse, it rapidly erodes the screw's surface due to localized shock waves against the blade surface. Tip vortex cavitation is caused by the extremely low pressures formed at the core of the tip vortex. The tip vortex is caused by fluid wrapping around the tip of the propeller, from the pressure side to the suction side. This video demonstrates tip vortex cavitation. Tip vortex cavitation typically occurs before suction side surface cavitation and is less damaging to the blade, since this type of cavitation doesn't collapse on the blade, but some distance downstream cavitation can be used as an advantage in design of very high-performance propellers, in form of the supercavitating propeller. In this case, the blade section is designed such that the pressure side stays wetted while the suction side is completely covered by cavitation vapor. Because the suction side is covered with vapor instead of water, it encounters very low viscous friction, making the supercavitating SC propeller comparably efficient at high speed. The shaping of SC blade sections, however, make it inefficient at low speeds. When the suction side of the blade is wetted, see also fluid dynamics. A similar, but quite separate issue, is ventilation, which occurs when a propeller operating near the surface draws air into the blades, causing a similar loss of power and shaft vibration, but without the related potential blade surface damage caused by cavitation. Both effects can be mitigated by increasing the submerged depth of the propeller. Cavitation is reduced because the hydrostatic pressure increases the margin to the vapor pressure, and ventilation because it is further from surface waves and other air pockets that might be drawn into the slipstream. The blade profile of propellers designed to operate in a ventilated condition is often not of an aerofoil section and is a blunt-ended taper instead. These are often known as chopper-type propellers. 14-ton propeller from Voroshilov, a Kirov-class cruiser on display in Sevastopol. Forces acting on a foil. The force F experienced by a foil is determined by its area A, fluid density rho, velocity V, and the angle of the foil to the fluid flow, called angle of attack. V2 equals FRN, comma, 1, 2. Rho V caret A and D equals CD, 1, 2. Rho V caret A, where CL and CD are lift coefficient and drag coefficient respectively. Each coefficient is a function of the angle of attack and Reynolds number. As the angle of attack increases, lift rises rapidly from the no lift angle before slowing its increase and then decreasing, with a sharp drop as the stall angle is reached and flow is disrupted. Drag rises slowly at first, and as the rate of increase in lift falls and the angle of attack increases, drag increases more sharply for a given strength of circulation. Lift equals L equals much in relation to the ambient pressure of the fluid. Cavitation occurs, bubbles form in the low pressure area and are moved towards the blade's trailing edge where they collapse as the pressure increases. This reduces propeller efficiency and increases noise. The forces generated by the bubble collapse can cause permanent damage to the surfaces of the blade. Propeller thrust, single blade taking an arbitrary radial section of a blade at R. If revolutions are N, then the rotational velocity is 2. If the blade was a complete screw, it would advance through a solid at the rate of Np, where P is the pitch of the blade. In water, the advance speed is rather lower, Va. The difference, or slip ratio, is slip equals Np. Anp equals 1. Equals equals 1, where J equals V. And is the advance coefficient, and P equals Pd is the pitch ratio. The forces of lift and drag on the blade, Da, where force normal to the surface is dl. DL equals 1, 2. 2 CL DA equals 1, 2. 1 A 2, 4. R 2, 1. BDRL equals rho V underscore caret C underscore DA equals rho C underscore BR, where V 1, 2 equals VA. 2, 1 A 2, 4.